Hi guys, how are you? Hope you are doing good. Welcome back to my channel Agriculture Makes Strong.
Let's study about growth stages of rice plant. What is meant by growth stages in any crop means the exact definition of the growth stages of a crop is an important for at least three reasons. Firstly, they affect the degree to which the disease severity is related to the yield, so that the damage thresholds vary depending on the growth stage of the crop at which the disease is measured. And it also shows the effective timing for the application of chemicals in the control of rice diseases requires a clear understanding of relationship between crop growth stages, the disease development and the yield. Recent studies on the importance of growth stage as a decision aid in the field management of blast and sheath blight diseases are discussed. Coming to the growth stages, first we have vegetation period, reproductive period and ripening period. Coming to the vegetation period, we have it 60 to 100 days. In reproductive period, it usually takes 35 days. Ripening period takes 30 days. Coming to the vegetative period, we have three stages. First is transplanting, tillering, stem elongation. After the vegetation period, they enter into the reproductive period with the panicle initiation, booting stage, flowering stage. After the flowering stage, they enter into the ripening period. It follows like milk stage, dow stage and mature stage. Let us discuss one by one in coming slides. Coming to the growth, discussed above, the growth stages in the rice are three stages: vegetative, reproductive, ripening. And in vegetation, it has transplanting to the germination, tillering, stem elongation includes. And reproductive stage, we have panicle initiation to the flowering stage, and flowering stage to the mature stage shows the ripening period. And coming to the stages in vegetative phase, germination, seedling, tillering, stem elongation, let us see one by one. Zero stage, it has germination to emergence. We discuss about germination of the paddy in this slide, where the germinating seed has the coleorrhiza, which protrudes the first, and the radical or primary root breaks through the covering, seminal roots and coleoptile emerging as a tapered cylinder. First, embryo starts to germinate. Variety, temperature, water and air affects the growth. End of the stage 0, three days after the sowing, first leaf arises. Coming to the next step, stage seedling. Seedling has leaves continue to develop at the end at the rate of the every 3 to 4 days during the early stage. The secondary adventitious roots replace the temporary radical. 20 to 25 days old seedling ready for the transplanting. You can observe in this image with the mesocotyl pushing the coleoptile above the soil surface, and first and second seedling leaf. Coming to the next stage, tillering stage. Stage 2, and coming to the tillering stage, tillers displace a leaf as they grow and develop. They extends from first tiller to maximum tillers. At maximum tiller stage, some tillers die or level off. Coming to the next stage 3, we have stem elongation. You can observe in the image the stem elongation. The stem elongation begins before panicle initiation in the late maturity varieties. In short duration varieties, stem elongation and panicle insertion occurs simultaneously. You can see the elongation of this stem depends on the growth duration. Short duration, we have 105 to 120 days. In long duration, 150 days. Coming to the next stage. Reproductive stage. In reproductive stage, we have panicle insertion to budding, and fifth one is heading flowering. Coming to the panicle insertion. Let us talk about panicle insertion, where it shows begins with the panicle primordium insertion at the tip of growing shoot. End of this stage, end panicle is about to emerge. Spikelets become distinct. You can observe in this image the panicle at the 7 to 10 days after the insertion. The end panicle increases in the size and it causes the bulging of flag leaf sheath. Coming to the next stage, heading. Let us discuss about heading stage, where head of the grain shows up and the 50% of the panicles have been exerted. Usually, it takes 10 to 14 days for all plants to complete the heading stage. Coming to the next flowering stage, we have anthesis, flowering. At flowering, the florets open, anthers protrude, and florets then close. It occurs about 25 days after the usual panicle insertion. Plant is most sensitive to the stress. You can observe the florets and the pollen and anther which protruded. Coming to the next stage, stages. Ripening stage. We have the ripening stage with the three stages: the milk grain stage, dough grain stage, mature grain stage. Let us discuss about the milk grain stage, where it shows the milky appearance. The grain starts to fill with a white milky liquid that can be squeezed out. The top of the panicle bends gently in an arc. The panicle and the three uppermost leaves are green. This is called the milk grain stage. And let us observe the next stage. We have dough stage. The dough stage has the noticeable changes, which is showing the changes like yellow color, spikelets, remaining leaves dry up and follows the senescence. Coming to the mature grain stage. The mature grain stage, we have the grains which are fully developed and they are mature, color golden yellow color and hard. Most of the upper leaves are dry and the panicles bend down as seen in the figure. And these are the growth stages of the paddy.
If you like this video, please subscribe to the channel for more updates.